going fast makes me feel alive. My heart beats in hyperdrive. Do you think you could win? Only if I lose, just let destiny choose.
What's up, everyone? NeoCypher here, getting back to Yu-Gi-Oh! Legacy of the Duelist Link Evolution. And welcome to what is by far the most difficult series yet. Because I'm still stuck on the third duel. This is, I kid you not, my fifth attempt at the facility. And I'll explain why here in a moment. Well, actually, you'll probably kind of see it in the story. So, Yusei gets captured by Sector Security at the Kaiba Dome, gets sent to court for sentencing, and gets put into a prison known as the facility, where he meets an old man named Tenzen. Yep. So, long story short, Tenzen got thrown in because of dueling, which his cards are actually illegal magic relics. Go figure, I've stopped questioning this universe. So, even though dueling is illegal inside the facility, the inmates still duel for respect. So they get confronted by Bolt Tanner. And what the story here doesn't show is that Tanner did duel against Tenzen, and Tenzen got his butt kicked. So Yusei decides to challenge Tanner, but uses Tenzin's deck. And that's where the difficulty of this duel lies. If you're doing the story duel, or using the story decks like I am, this is not the greatest deck. The relic cards in Tenzin's deck are not great alone, but they work well together. I've had a couple of my losses go pretty close. One loss, I got it down to 200 life points left. I just couldn't finish him off. So this might be, I've said this a couple of times, but this might be the first duel where I have to start using my own custom deck. Because this is not a great deck for this duel. We're gonna see what Tanner does. Yeah, that thing. Jiraigumo is good. When he clears an attack, he tosses the coin. If he calls it wrong, he loses half his life points. Now, let's see what we have here. We have a Chronomaly Crystal Skull. If you control a Chronomaly monster, you can discard this card from the graveyard. Hang on. If you control a Chronomaly monster, you can discard this card to the graveyard. Add one Chronomaly monster from your deck or graveyard to your hand, except Crystal Skull. Moai. If you control a Chronomaly monster, you can special summon this card from your hand in defense position. You can banish this card from your graveyard, target one level 3 or higher attack position monster on the field, change it to face up or face down defense mode. The effect of Chronomaly Colossal Head can only be used once per turn. Okay, this one I've never seen. Each time this card destroys an opponent's monster and sends to the graveyard to resolve the battle, increases this card by 700 points. Chronomaly Crystal Skull, we just said that, okay. So this is going to be interesting. This is going to get interesting. I might be able to pull off getting rid of his card right off the get-go. Because I can make sure I'm doing this right. Oh, maybe never mind. That gets changed to summoning defense mode. So I can't do it this turn. Alright, Well, right off, we're going to go and play Mask of the Accursed. The equipped monster cannot attack once per turn during standby phase. I inflict 500 damage to the controller of the equipped monster. So that now can't attack. We're going to summon Chronomaly Colossal Head. Because of that, I can now go ahead and do Chronomaly Moai in defense mode. Activate the effect of this so I can see what's in my deck here. And this, I believe, goes to my hand. So I won't be able to use Chronomaly Crystal Bones yet. Muscle head. I can also do another Moai if I wanted to. Classic Mask during the turn view. I've activated Chronomaly spell previously this turn, which I've not. Because basically, I have no way right now of getting a second monster in attack mode. So we're going to go ahead and do this. I can still go and special summon it. Well, set it. And that is it. The fact that when we play the one monster is... Okay. Ushioni, that's fine. Oh, boy. Not out of the woods yet. Actually, only monster can attack instead of you. The opponent takes the bound damage you have taken. So now the woods yet. Now I know what I want to get. This is going to be risky, but I'm going to go for it. I want to summon this monster. I'm going to change both these to attack position before I forget to do so. Activate this effect. Vex tributed. That goes to zero. That's destroyed. Main phase, we're going to go and put down Dimension Wall. So if he attacks with something big, it's going to go right around and hit him instead. This is actually the best position I've been in so far in this duel. So my monster still goes away, but he takes the 2,000 points of damage. Looking through here. Banished Guard from Graveyard. Target one level 3 or higher attack position monster in the field. Change the face up, face down, defense position. Actually, no. I do still want to do that. Not that's going to matter, but there we go. Gonna summon this one. battle phase. What's interesting is that in the actual duel in the anime, Yusei wins and he never has to attack once. All of his damage is done through card effects. Again, this is the best position we've been in, but it's nowhere near over, probably. I'm curious about that now. Okay, I'm gonna go and summon. M is the infinity. Probably going to regret this, but... I screwed up. Crap, I misread that. No, I forgot. I had to pick a face-up monster. I screwed that up. Okay, he didn't attack, though. So I kind of screwed that up. All right. And I gained 700 attack. Yeah, that was a goof on my part. I was thinking for some reason you can flip that face up, but... And he's got nothing. We might actually finally be done with this. We finally done with this duel? Alright, we are finally done with this friggin' duel. Holy cow. It's a rare instance where a misplay of mine doesn't turn to a major loss. So yeah, basically we gain Tanner's respect. And once help you say, pretty much become a pro. Alright, so we have opened up the next campaign duel, the lockdown duel. The reverse duel for the facility. The Bolt Tanner deck avatar. His Raging Battleaxe deck recipe. The Fabled Awakening challenge deck. Ushioni. Manticore Darkness. Vorce Raider. And 1444 victory duel points. I got 100 points for the win, 24 for number of turns, 2 for spells, 2 for traps, 4 for tributes, 6 for controlling a monster with high attack, 12 for maximum damage inflicted, 24 for difference in life points, 4 for max damage reflected, and 10 by inflicting battle damage only. Which is the exact opposite of how the actual anime went, where Yusei inflicted no battle damage the entire time. Seriously, it's an interesting... I think it's a two-parter. The second part was the actual duel between Yusei and Tanner, if I recall. Definitely worth checking out, though. And so next we have the lockdown duel. So, yeah, I'm just happy to finally be done with that. Again, I am fully expecting 5Ds to be a lot more difficult series than the original. And, GX, had to think there for a second. I don't mind challenging duels. Nothing could be worse than having to deal with the freaking spirit board stuff from Yami Bakura. I don't think anything can top that annoyance. But with that, that's all I've got for this video. I thank you guys for watching. I hope you're enjoying the series so far, and I shall see you next time. See the sun arise and fire.